Hi, hello. I am G.V. Srinivasa Rao, principal, Atomic Energy Central School, Kodankulam. Today's topic is Atomic Structure, Module 1. In the first chapter, Basic Concepts of Chemistry, we studied the Dalton's Atomic Theory, in which we learned that matter is made up of very small particles called atoms. According to Dalton's theory, atoms cannot be divided into further smaller particles. But experiments conducted by scientists in the second half of the 19th century proved that atom is made of further smaller particles called elementary particles or subatomic particles or fundamental particles. In lower classes, you studied that atom is made of electrons, protons and neutrons, which are nothing but fundamental particles. Before starting the lesson, let us have the basic knowledge of charge and mass of these fundamental particles. Fundamental particles, electrons, protons and neutrons. Relative charge on electron is minus 1 unit and proton has plus 1 unit. Charge in coulombs, electron has minus 1.6021 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs, whereas proton has the same charge, but the magnitude of charge is different, that is, it has positive charge. Relative mass of electron is 1/1837th part of a proton, whereas proton and neutron, they are considered to have 1 unit of mass. Charge in kilograms, electron has 9.109 into 10 to the power minus 31 kilograms, whereas proton has 1.672 into 10 to the power minus 28 kilograms and neutron has 1.674 into 10 to the power minus 28 kilograms. This is mass in atomic units. Electron has 0.00054 atomic mass unit. Proton has 1.00727 atomic mass units, whereas neutron has 1.00867 atomic mass units. The pressure of different gases can be made by evacuation of gases in the glass tube. When sufficiently high voltage is applied across the electrodes, the current starts flowing and a stream of particles start moving from negative electrode to positive electrode. The flow of current was checked by making a hole in the anode and coating the tube with phosphorescent material like zinc sulfide. This stream is called cathode rays. Here you can see the discharge tube. This is a cathode and this is anode. These metallic plates are connected to the terminals of a battery, which gives a high voltage. And this is the side tube through which air inside the tube can be removed. When the pressure is about 0.01 millimeter and the voltage is about 10,000 volts, then current starts passing from cathode to anode and we can see the fluorescence or glow or scintillations on the anode side. Characteristics of cathode rays. Cathode rays themselves are not visible, but their behavior can be observed with the help of a certain kind of materials, that is fluorescent or phosphorescent, which glow when hit by them. So cathode rays are invisible. Cathode rays travel in straight lines. If an object is kept in their path, their shadow is casted on the opposite side, that is cathode side. They cause heating effect. When cathode rays fall on any metal surface, it is heated to red. They exert mechanical pressure. When an aluminium paddle wheel is kept in their path, it rotates, showing that they are made of material particles. When cathode rays fall on heavy metals, they cause X-rays. Deflection in the presence of a magnetic field. Cathode rays deflect in the magnetic field, indicating that these rays are made of material particles which are charged. This we can observe from a small video. Any radiation deviates its path in the presence of a magnetic field. This indicates that the radiation is charged. If we bring a strong magnet near the cathode ray tube in which the cathode rays are produced, the rays deviate from their original path, that is, they bend. This indicates that cathode rays are charged. Deflection in the presence of electric field. Cathode rays deflect in electric field towards anode, indicating that they are negatively charged particles. From all the properties we discussed, we can understand that cathode rays are made of material particles with negative charge, and they are called as electrons. In this video, a strong electric field is brought near to the cathode ray tube. The cathode rays bend towards the positively charged electrode. This indicates that cathode rays are negatively charged. In 1897, Thomson measured the ratio of electric charge to the mass of an electron by applying suitable electric field and magnetic field. By applying electric field strength and magnetic field strength, it is possible to bring back the path of electrons in its original path, which is followed in the absence of electric field or magnetic field. From his experiments, Thomson stated that relation between deflection of cathode rays and field strength, magnitude of charge on the particle. Greater the magnitude of charge on the particle, greater is the deflection. Mass of the particle, lighter the particle, greater is the deflection. If the particle is heavier, deflection is less. Strength of electric or magnetic field, deflection of electron from its original path with the increase in voltage across the electrodes or strength of the magnetic field. By carrying the accurate measurements of the strength of electric field or magnetic field, Thomson is able to determine the value of E by M. E by M equal to 1.758820 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kilogram. R.A. Millikan in 1909 conducted his oil drop experiment, which led to find the charge on an electron. This experiment, oil drops in the form of mist is produced by an atomizer, and the mist of oil drops were allowed to enter through a small hole in the upper plate. The motion of these particles can be viewed through a microscope equipped with a counter. Air inside the chamber was ionized by passing the X-rays. The electric charge on these oil drops were acquired by the collision of oil drops with ions of air. The fall of these droplets can be slowed down or accelerated or prevented depending upon the charge on droplets and the strength of the voltage applied. By carefully measuring the effects of electric field strength with the motion of the oil drops, Millikan concluded that the magnitude of electric charge Q on the droplets is always an integral multiple of electric charge C, that is Q equal to Ne, where N equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. From Thomson experiment, E by M ratio of electron was found as 1.758820 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kilogram, or it is equal to 1.758820 into 10 to the power 8 coulomb per gram. From Millikan experiment, the charge on electron was calculated as 1.6022 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So in a E by M ratio, if we apply these values, the mass of an electron can be calculated as 9.0194 into 10 to the power minus 28 gram.
In a series of experiments carried out between 1908 and 1917, R.A. Millikan succeeded in measuring the charge of the electron with great precision. In his experiment, a fine mist of oil was sprayed into the upper chamber with an atomizer. Some of the tiny oil droplets fell through the hole in the upper floor, and Millikan was able to determine the mass of an oil drop from its terminal velocity. Next, Millikan used an X-ray source to ionize gas molecules in the chamber, Electrons from this ionization process adhered to the oil droplets. The oil droplets now carry a negative charge. The negatively charged oil droplets can be halted by adjusting the voltage across the two plates. As the voltage across the plates is increased, the velocity of the oil drops slows. As the voltage is increased further, some drops will begin to move upward toward the positive plate. If the voltage is set just right, an oil drop can be suspended. When an oil drop is suspended, its weight, mass times acceleration due to gravity, is exactly counterbalanced by the electric force applied. The electric force applied equals the applied electric field, E, times the charge on the drop, Q. Since the mass of the oil drop, the acceleration due to gravity, and the applied electric field are known, Millikan could solve for Q, which is the charge on the drop. Millikan found that droplets had different charges, but each was a whole number multiple of a smaller charge, equal to negative 1.60 times 10 to the negative 19th coulombs. Millikan concluded that this was the fundamental unit of charge, the charge of an electron. From the charge of an electron and the charge-to-mass ratio of an electron determined by Thomson using a cathode ray tube, Millikan was able to calculate the mass of an electron. The mass of an electron, 9.10 times 10 to the negative 28th grams, is an exceedingly small mass.
For better understanding, some YouTube videos have been used here. In the next module, we learn Rutherford's alpha ray scattering experiment and his model and defects. Thank you.